Now, out on the back row in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I'm Rich Picard. I'm the program manager for the Liquid Rocket Lab here at Cal Poly Pomona. We received a $1.67 million donation from the National Colleges Resource Foundation. The reason we got the grant was not just to launch a rocket, it was really to build a liquid rocket program here at Cal Poly, to really get it part of Cal Poly's core education. And, you know, as a learn by doing school, we really strive for hands-on student projects. And with this program going the way it is, we're going to have students working on this program 10, 15, 30 years down the road.
They wanted a place where students could come to learn rocketry so that they could get involved in industry, in the aerospace industry, doing this as a profession. So there's going to be a lot of student-involved learning, student-involved designing, and they're taking the concept of getting to space and actually making it a reality, part of the mantra for Cal Poly.
Since then, we've been able to develop labs, get equipment, get tools, and most importantly, get training and hands-on experience for the students to really learn what making rockets is all about. So what I do on the project is I mostly oversee all three teams, the launch vehicle, the mobile rocket engine test stand, MRETS, and the engine team.
My name is Will Morris, and I am Launch Vehicle Team Lead for the Liquid Rocket Lab. My job primarily involves coordinating a pretty large team of students. That involves a lot of CADing, a lot of engineering drawings, a lot of design work overall.
My name is Ethan Sickler, and I am the Engine Team Lead. I'm responsible for essentially the whole design of the liquid rocket engine that's being built to propel the Bronco 1 launch vehicle. And so this includes structural analysis, thermal analysis, pressure drop calculations, the whole system design.
My name is Edwin Battati, and I am the lead on the Mobile Rocket Engine Test Stand Team, or MRETS. What involves in going into this test stand is find out what an engine is capable of producing in terms of its thrust, how high it's going to go, all the numbers and data that a team would need to characterize the performance of a rocket engine. The trailer is a pretty critical component. What the trailer is going to do is it's going to house its own propellant system, also going to house its own data acquisition system, and also a full-on assembly to compensate for all the loading that the engine's going to generate. So there's a sufficient amount of thrust that's going to be going into the trailer itself from the engine.
It's a long road, but we think we can do it if we start nailing down these smaller competitions. We can eventually build up to making our system get to space.
We would love for Cal Poly Pomona to be the first university to go to space. The team is holding up really well. I couldn't ask for a better team. We struggle a lot just because it's so new to us, and this is the first time Cal Poly's ever attempted to do a project this ambitious before regarding liquid rockets.
It's insanely hard, but it's really fun. It's a really rewarding project. I love this. It's quite an experience.
Building a rocket engine has really, really been a unique opportunity, and getting this program started was kind of a dream come true.